It's the worst of the Opie and Anthony show.
You know who's the real McCoy? Pat Cooper. Pat Cooper,
yeah,
is the real fucking McCoy.
Yeah, that guy's out of his mind. Definitely.
You know, he's not that motherfucker, so.
He doesn't hold back.
Yeah, Pat Cooper's trashing us the other day, actually.
He trashes everybody, and it wasn't, I don't even think it was a legitimate trashing of us.
I have no idea what he was trying to say.
He's trashing us.
I would love
us
to get him on the show to talk about this.
He was trashing us to
you're
trash
us up
Howard.
For a lot of bits. We happen to have Pat Cooper audio on.
Are you joking me?
And he's trashing us.
Please.
He's trashing us in order to trash Howard. He was trashing Howard, saying, why did you make these guys famous? It's your fault that these guys are millionaires, and it's because of you. Because you, you know, brought them attention.
I bet you if you called Pat, he'd fucking talk to you.
He wouldn't in a second, I know.
He's not a phony. Yeah, that old man is
just a crotchety old fucker.
He is not fucking around.
Well, someone get the word out to Pat Cooper. We'll have him in.
Didn't they, like, throw him out of the Friars Club or something?
Oh, my God.
So obnoxious.
He was talking about Rodney Dangerfield when he was dying. So it was so fucking brutal.
Who cares about Rodney Dangerfield?
He said, if I'm walking around with a coconut on my head, shoot me. And then Rodney had, like, a tumor. He said, if I'm walking around with a coconut growing on my head, just throw me out the window.
That's funny, man.
Pat Cooper is not a bullshit motherfucker, man.
Throw me out the window.
And Rodney Dangerfield would appreciate that joke.
Yeah.
We'll try to do this real fast before a break. All right. It's Pat Cooper trashing us in some bizarre way.
Let me tell you something. Anybody can be tough when they got the microphone and I can't answer. Now I got the microphone and I'm going to tell Howard Stern he's full of shit. Let's start with that. He turns around and says, I can't handle fame. I left the Howard Stern show because Howard Stern made an ass of himself when he started fighting with Opie and Anthony.
What are you talking about?
And when he makes Opie and Anthony become big heads, beat his ass, and I said, it's time for me to go away. Because Opie and Anthony, he made them millionaires. You know what Howard made me? $35 a week. That's the fucking difference. People who help them, he don't help.
See, Pat Cooper.
Nah, I see it as
just, absolutely not a trash.
Well, what happened was when Pat Cooper found out that Howard Stern had a gag order on us, he couldn't believe it. And he's a stand-up guy. He said, you know what? I can't be part of your crap. If you're putting gag orders on fellow radio guys.
That was years ago when Pat he stopped doing Stern.
Yeah.
Years.
Some of the funniest Pat Cooper and some of the funniest moments on Stern's show was when Pat Cooper was on. Remember years ago. Who told you that? When he just kept yelling that over and over again. Got funnier every time.
What does he mean by Howard made us famous?
He's saying that, you hear at the end, he goes, what does he made me? $35? He's like, why would he give you guys
the time of day? Right.
So basically what it's saying is it's like you look up to somebody or you respect somebody. It's just like if I look at you guys like, you know what? Y'all some serious. If I'm out there going, these two are some serious motherfuckers. And then like Joe Blow, the new radio guy, comes around and he goes, you two bitch ass niggas. And y'all go, hey, man, forget him. That guy's an asshole. Yeah, I don't want to deal with him. Pat's kind of like, what, motherfucker? And I can't make money. He's saying, why not him?
He shouldn't have given us the time of day.
Right. It's like you represented. Basically, he's giving you a compliment because he's saying you're the guys.
Right.
He could have said anybody.
He's disappointed in Howard that Howard didn't try to fight back. Instead, went behind the scenes with the gag order shit. He couldn't believe that someone like Howard would do that.
Because that's not the Howard that he thought he knew. Right. He's saying, all like, right, fucking, he let you guys fucking.
And he's just a crotchety old fuck.
And he's a fucking, even if he is trashing you,
all right, here we
he's
go.
Pat Cooper. Yeah.
I take it as a compliment. It's kind of fun.
He's a brutal animal.
Yeah. More audio.
People who help them, he don't help. But he helps fucking Opie and Anthony.
But I don't understand.
Barry, I never heard from you.
Wait a minute. What are you talking about?
Shut up,
Robin. Because he's telling everybody I left because I can't handle fame. That's bullshit.
No, that's not true. That's not what he said.
That's not what he ever said.
No, no, he never said that.
He said it a couple of weeks ago. Don't tell me he didn't say
that. He said that that's one aspect of your personality is that you can't handle fame, but that's not why you left the show.
Yeah, but I got to know, why did you leave the show? Because
I left it because when I saw the energy that he made two assholes big stars for no fucking reason.
But how did he do that? I don't know.
Holy shit. See, that
two
was...
Two assholes big stars for no fucking reason.
But what's the problem with that, you two assholes?
We are assholes. I'll give him that. We are assholes.
But he makes it think that Howard made us famous. You gotta work at this shit every day. You can't just go on the radio and wait for someone to start talking about you, and then you become famous. You become big in this industry because you work your balls off and come up with some interesting radio.
I think he knows innately that I don't think Howard made you. I think he's saying the energy that he put into you guys.
Yeah.
Not that he said, oh, I touched these guys and made them. He's saying, motherfucker, put that energy into me. Why are you putting energy into these two motherfuckers?
Right, right. Don't even waste.
Because he did mention the money. I made $35 from...
$35.
Yeah.
Let's go back to this.
That he made two assholes, big stars, for no fucking reason.
But how did he do that? I don't know.
Opie and Anthony, he said, don't you talk to me. I won't talk to you. You're taking my material. I said, he's taking your material. Howard, how the fuck he take your material? There's only one you, Howard. Why do you make assholes get you angry? You can't play in my yard. You got the ball. That's bullshit. So you know what I said? All his energy... on two assholes. Why not use the energy on people who do his show much more better than those two fucking assholes? Why make them millionaires? Why? Because he made them start.
I don't think that was his intention. Yes, you have no idea why he took the attitude toward them that
I know. He
did.
Said they were stealing my material.
But that's what he
does
said.
Howard Stern own the... Does Howard Stern own the bout? Does Howard Stern say, I owe you? Who the fuck does this man think? He's not Jesus Christ.
And what should he
give
have done
fucking
for
break.
You? What should he have
no, wait a minute. Give
you?
Me a fucking break. This man don't walk on fucking water.
You're saying that energy was misdirected on those two guys that could have gone to people that he liked. So what energy did you not get from him?
My argument is this. Why waste your time that these two assholes become bigger when they shouldn't, because they're dickheads. These two fucking guys are dickheads. You got great guests, not me.
I'll give them
that. Great guests. Push them. Help them. Pick them up in a car once in a fucking while. They got to take a fucking subway 6 a.m.
I blame
cut
that,
the shit.
I blame that on Les Moonves.
Am I right? Did you pick up anybody with a car? Howard don't go for shit for when it comes to picking up a fucking car, for picking up a check. Where is he? If I work for Howard Stern,
I genuinely
I tell him, Howard, you're full of shit when he is full of shit.
Pat, I genuinely don't see how he made the millionaires. I don't see that correlation.
Because of the publicity. Made every paper in the country. Hello?
For like a minute. And then.
How about a week and a half, 2 weeks? Everybody said, Pat, what is this man? I said, because Howard don't see the forest for the fucking trees. He's jealous they're going to take his material. He's got no fucking material. He is what he is. He's a genius of him fucking self. I'm a genius of myself. I'm A-plus company. You understand?
So
I do.
Wait a minute. You throw your friend under the bus because you see him making a mistake?
No. That's not a mistake. That's not a mistake, honey. That's not thinking. He's a genius, goes to college, and he says, let's get two dickheads and make them popular. Fuck them. They're two dickheads. Oh, by the way.
You two fucking dickheads.
I was around Howard Stern was picking ants with his fucking nose.
Right.
Let's start that.
But what is that? But I don't understand what that means.
See, basically...
That is so funny.
You cannot be mad at Pat Cooper.
No.
He's just brutal.
No.
He's brutalizing the entire envelope. He's just peeing on the world.
He is...
Fuck you, fuck Stern.
He's a machine gunner spinning in circles.
He's not no bullshit.
He's just wiping everybody out.
Fuck everybody.
He don't care. He doesn't care.
You could have been anybody,
yeah.
Motherfucking, but you
didn't matter.
The compliment is that you were the dude. You are specifically the dudes who he thinks have hit that mantle.
Right.
He didn't mention anybody else.
No.
So to him, it's like he made you guys. You know, you the guys. But it could have been anybody. He's looking at you as the guys that ain't him.
I take it as I'm flattered. To be shit on by Pat Cooper.
I think that's a fucking tremendous
thing. I'm flattered
to
be shit on by Pat Cooper. God bless him.
Get Pat Cooper on the
phone. God bless Pat Cooper.
Get him on the phone.
I love him. He's just an angry... He was throwing punches everywhere.
Just a angry... He is legitimately a throwback to, like, man.
Oh,
there's someone out there that knows Pat Cooper. Get him to call the show.
But what was he on? Was he on the show?
No.
It's the show after the show.
After the show.
Don't you know how that works over there, Patrice? It's all about Howard. So he does his show, and then after Howard's show, there's a show that they do about the show you just heard. I kid you not.
Was he on the show?
No, Howard doesn't do that.
No, he's not allowed.
Howard does his show.
He's not allowed on the show. He's allowed on the after show.
No, Pat Cooper wasn't on the show.
That's right.
Right. Oh, okay.
He was on the after the show?
Yeah. And Howard doesn't do the after show. See, Pat was on the after show, not good enough for the show.
Right.
But then they do the after show, and then there's news.
It's like, you know,
about the show and the after show, and then they replay
it's
the
kinda
show.
Like, it's kind of like the post Super Bowl show, and you're a football player, and they just let you kind of throw some passes.
This from the guy that wouldn't sell T-shirts or coffee mugs with his image because he was worried about overexposure.
There you go. Let's get through the Pat Cooper audio. There's like a minute left here. Get Pat Cooper on this damn radio program, please.
Dickheads and make them popular. Fuck them. They're two dickheads. Oh, by the way, I was around before Howard Stern was picking ants with his fucking nose.
Right.
Let's start back.
Hard bar but, that, but I don't that's get
what
funny.
That means. Because he's not the only one to do what he has been doing. That's been done for years. He got in the door because he did it the right way.
But he's doing it the best now.
I didn't say no. The man is
Gary,
a fucking
relax.
Genius. As, my, as far as I'm
time.
Concerned. A fucking genius. Anybody that loves Stan Kinison, it can't Stan be that Kinison? Fucking dumb.
Was that revisionist history, or am I missing something?
That's how I see it.
Big time. Robin and I were just saying, I remember he was mad about the Opie and Anthony thing, but the thing that he was mad about was not that Howard made the millionaires. His exact quote was, when he could be quoted this way, was, who the fuck is Howard to tell anybody what to do?
Right.
That's what it was. That's what the anger was. Not about he made these two idiots millionaires. That's new.
Yeah, all of a sudden now, it's Howard wasn't good to his friends.
Guys like that are so classic for like what they focus on. Like, why is he so focused on Opie and Anthony? Like, why is that an issue?
Yeah, why should he even care about
that? Yeah, like Howard's opinion of them, like, what does that involve?
Yeah, you know what? If I could have thought of all the things that would have alienated us from Pat, that would have been like 150th on my list.
Yeah, it's just weird that he's focusing on that. It's hilarious.
No, it's a great point, you know?
It's a good point because he said, Howard, who's been the champion of free speech in a lot of people's eyes.
And taking on all the enemies and all that.
Yeah. Things
and
like that.
All other radio shows. We're the first radio show he did not take on, by the way. First one.
Yeah, not on the radio behind the scenes.
And the only one, by
did.
The way.
Thank you very much.
But he didn't. He knew he didn't have what it took to take us on. You know, with his his radio show.
So Pat got pissed about that, and God bless Pat was able to go right up to his face and say, "Look, you told him to shut up. You made them. You went to the boss and made them not talk about you anymore. And I got a problem with that." Good. I find it fun when he calls us dickheads and assholes. It's hysterical to me.
And he'll be on the phone. I guarantee you he'll call you dickheads on the phone.
Yeah.
You
fine.
Two dickheads.
He says nothing for me.
Let's get Pat Cooper on the air.
Yeah.
I don't know how we do
book
that.
Him.
I think he was trying to get on our show a while back. Maybe we have a number for him.
Yeah, book him.
Let's go to Lou in New York. Lou?
Hey, hi, guys.
Hey.
I got a little information on Pat. Matter of fact, I know you guys from the downtown. I did your...
Are you a friend of Pat Cooper's?
Yes, I am.
Then tell him to call the show right now.
Well, I don't have his number. Put it this way, I'm an acquaintance. I used to work some shows with him. Just to let you know that he is that way on and off stage. The man is never off.
All right, well, we just want to get him on the show. It's great, you know, you're a friend of his, but, you know, try to get a hold of him for us.
If I can, I certainly will try. And you guys are great. I'm probably one of your oldest listeners. I'm at 60 years old, but you guys make me laugh every day.
All right, Lou. Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care.
So there you go.
Yeah, Pat. That was good.
Ben sent Pat an email.
You two dickheads.
Good. We'll have him on tomorrow, I bet
you. Yeah, dickheads and assholes.
You dickheads.
Or
you
later today.
Dickheads.
Them millionaires.
No, I mean, you still got to work at the job.
Yeah. Don't worry about it.
You know, we knew when we came to New York that it'd be a smart move to get under Howard's skin. We knew that, of course.
After we got an audience.
Yeah, of course we knew that. But you also have to do compelling radio on a daily basis.
When he left originally, it was because that the gag order.
That
put
pissed
on
him off.
Yes, absolutely.
But why didn't he come? I guess I answered my own question. But why didn't he come to you guys, like to say, you know, he just goes...
Because we're assholes and dickheads.
You're dickheads, right? He's like, fuck you,
why go on that show?
The gag order, by the way, you know, that was well reported. Funny. You could Google that and read about that. That was a fun few months.
Hey, this is Patrice O'Neill. You are listening to the worst of Opie and Anthony. I guess which is their best, really. You know, when you think...